When I review reports with patients, particularly ultrasound reports, often it may say right in the body of the report, dilated ducts. Wow, that gets the patient's attention. Good grief, Dr. Harness, what are dilated ducts and what are they about? Well, first of all, dilated ducts are typically diagnosed with ultrasound. It's the best technology we have, short of putting a catheter inside a duct in the nipple and squirting some dye in. It's the best technology that we have to see the ductal system of the breast and to see if there's any pathology or abnormalities associated with the ductal system. Now, when would this typically come up? Well, usually it comes up if the patient comes in complaining of a nipple discharge. The nipple discharge can consist of blood. A greenish fluid is a good example, or very occasionally, almost like a toothpaste, anchovy paste-like sort of discharge. So the ultrasound examination becomes really key in making a non-ductogram, if you will, a non-little catheter in the duct diagnosis of what's going on. So ducts can dilate up for a variety of reasons. Of course, if a patient is pregnant, her ductal system is going to dilate up in order to deliver milk out. So we're not talking about that here. If there is a narrowing of the ductal system, typically seen with fibrocystic changes of the breast, particularly in women in their 40s, the ducts coming up to that narrowing dilate up. In fact, if the duct gets pinched off by the process, the duct can dilate up so much that it forms a cyst. Another reason the ducts can dilate up is if there's a little overgrowth going on inside the duct called a intra, meaning inside, ductal, inside the duct, papilloma, a benign overgrowth, can then sort of partially obstruct the ductal system and cause it to dilate up. Can you see dilated ducts with in situ breast cancer? You can indeed. Not very typical. What do we do about dilated ducts? And one more thought before I get into that. There is an entity called ductal ectasia. Big fancy medical word. Ectasia meaning dilatation. Ductal ectasia that can cause the ducts to dilate up. This can be seen people as young as children, well up into adult life. The cause, or the medical term for that is etiology. The cause for ductal ectasia is unknown. There's some thought that maybe there's some chronic inflammation going on. And with this unusual diagnosis of ductal ectasia, you can get a nipple discharge, sometime almost like a toothpaste-like discharge. So what do we do about the dilated ducts? Well, frankly, we may do nothing. If the ductal system is discharging out through the nipple, then a ductogram is indicated. This is a very, very fine little catheter that the radiologist can thread down into the duct that's discharging, squirt a little dye in, and see what's underlying, and we can visualize the ductal system that way. In most instances, you actually then want to operate, because often you find one of these benign intraductal papillomas, and surgically you want to remove that by an incision around the edge of the areola. So what's the take-home message? Take-home message is, by and large, dilation or dilatation, if you will, of the ducts is a benign process, often associated with a nipple discharge, can be seen with fibrocystic changes of the breast, ductal ectasia, or intraductal papillomas, and very unusual associated with in situ breast cancer. As always, if this is the case for you, please get yourself into the hands of a multidisciplinary team used to handling this problem. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor. I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.